In this question, we're asked to show that a set S is not a subspace. Now, there's a very particular way in which I recommend you go about these questions. The first step along the way is to look at the set S and think, what is this object? Well, we can see that the vector v is just 1, 2, 3 from R3, and lambda v, where lambda ranges between 0 and 10, is a line segment from the origin, which is 0v, all the way out to 10v. So that's S, that's the beast we're dealing with here. When you're showing something is not a vector space, you need to choose one of the vector space axioms and show that the set S violates that axiom. Okay, because S lives in R3, a known vector space, most of the vector space axioms are going to hold for free. The only ones that possibly don't hold are inclusion of zero, closure under addition, and closure under scalar multiplication. So let's go through these in turn. It does actually contain zero. Zero is in S. So that's the first possible vector space axiom put aside. That one's actually satisfied. What about closure under scalar multiplication? I know I can go from V all the way out and stretch that out to 10V, but I can't go to 11V. And that's how I'm going to show that this set is not closed under scalar multiplication, and thereby is not a vector space. So you see, the first step here is to think about what S is and decide which of the vector space axioms it violates, and along the way you need to figure out precise values for all your objects. You need a precise value for an element of the space and a scalar you're going to multiply it by. You can't just do this in general for some arbitrary vectors and scalars. You need to be explicit about what you're doing. So I'm going to be very explicit. I'm going to let lambda be equal to 11. There we are. 11. You don't get more explicit than that. And I'm going to let x be a vector, and it's just going to be v, which in particular, I need to show that this is in the set. So I'll say that's equal to 1v, which is in S, since x is just equal to lambda v, where the lambda in this case is just 1. So 0 is less than or equal to 1. Is less than or equal to 10. So when something is closed under scalar multiplication, you start within the set and you stretch it, and you're supposed to be in the set still. That means I need to establish that I'm already in the set. So X is in the set. I can't just scalar multiply some random vector by 11, find that it's not in the set, and say, hey, S isn't closed under scalar multiplication. No. You need to start from a vector which is in S, and you need to be very explicit about what that vector is. So here I'm being as explicit as I possibly could, or can be. Lambda is 11, X is V. X is in S. But 11 times X is equal to 11V, which is not in S, since 11 is greater than 10. So it can't be in S because it's in the shape lambda v, but lambda is too big to be in S. So S is not closed under scalar multiplication, and therefore S cannot be a vector subspace of R3. Thank you.